Association is becoming a member of INET. So for all information about membership and other activities, so please do visit the INET website, www.theinet.net. So wishing you all a very great learning session. I take your leave. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Dr. Dixit.
So over to Pratishti.
Thank you very much. Before I introduce today's speaker, our resource person for the webinar, I would just like to recall a few instructions for all the participants here. I request everybody to keep their videos and microphones off. At the end of the seminar, we'll share a feedback form link with everybody, and the feedback link forms, it will be valid only for 3 hours. So you will get 3 hours time after the concluding of the webinar to fill your feedback. So filling of the feedback is extremely necessary to be eligible to get a certificate for today's webinar. Now further, I would like to introduce today's erudite speaker with us, Dr. Vivek Joshi. He's MA, MPhil in English and PhD and certificate critical thinking from Oregon, USA. He is associate professor in the PG department of English, Gondwana University. Besides, he has also had many professional standings. For example, he has been the president of the All India Network of English Teachers, INET. He is ex-dean arts faculty, Gondwana University. He is ex-member management council, arts faculty, Gondwana University. He is former member board of studies in languages, science faculty, Gondwana University. He has more than 27 years of experience of teaching, besides publishing many scholarly articles and conference presentations. He has participated in varied projects like Chapter Leadership Development Program for Consolidation of LTI, supported by IATFL and Hornby Trust, UK. He is he is affiliated to International Association of Teachers of English as a Foreign Language, IATFL UK. He's currently the president of INET. He's member Bhandara English Teachers Club and Gondwana University English Teachers Club. He also does quite a number of editorial work besides doing quite a number of philanthropic activities, for example, fundraising for the tsunami victims and the teaching community developmental activities. So we are very, very excited to listen to Dr. Joshi. Rather, as William Harvey says, what is research but a blind date with knowledge? So over to you, Dr. Joshi.
Thank you very much, Pratishruti, for inviting me for this webinar. And I'm overwhelmed by this introduction. Which I wish get reflected in my presentation during this, whatever time you will allow me to do. Hello, all participants. Let me share my screen now. Is the screen visible?
Yeah, it is.
And my audio?
Yeah, you are also audible.
Okay. As Dr. Head of the Humanities Department, Dr. Mehra, has suggested that I will be speaking about very relevant and sought after topic, how to choose a research topic in English literature that appears on the screen now. And you will understand that they are praising wrong person, wrong way. A person who don't even know how to spell and write title of the webinar, how that person is going to speak. So welcome for this presentation, dear friends. Sir, how do I disappear?
You switch off your camera.
How do I do that?
On the top, you will see just a small strip. You take your cursor to the strip, so the controls will appear. There is a small strip on your screen.
And at the bottom of the screen.
The green and red strip.
There's a status bar.
No, since he is sharing, probably he will see a strip at the top, a green and black. You just take your cursor there, the control will appear where you can choose to switch off your camera. I can do it for you if you want.
Please do so.
No, it's all right now. You have switched off your camera.
Thank you very much, Dr. Amol, for helping me in this technical English. Dear friends, we are here to talk about much sought after area or that we all as a research scholar wish to find answer, and that is how to choose a research topic in then in bracket English literature. Friends, I'm sure today in this session I am going to speak with the mixed kind of audience, where it's possible that some budding research scholars are also is a part of this particular population, and some seasoned researchers who are into this since long, and it would be very wonderful experience for me as a speaker to understand the expectations of the audience and match them through this particular talk of almost 1 hour. And I would be grateful for all the inputs that you would be offering to me during my talk. As Pratishutya suggested, research is very, in a way, ambiguous term, and too verbose, too complicated to define in a maybe concise sentence or so. Many scholars have attempted to define research in many ways. The one definition that Pratishutya offered at the beginning was one of them. And it may include, it's a very big umbrella where many things are possible around. And the researcher, this pose as a challenge in a way, to cope up with this mixture of maybe some illusion or maybe some mixture of some heterogeneous activities and heterogeneity in a way. And we are going to talk about some of them. I'm sure the period or the time limit that this particular session may have will not let us discuss all the issues related with this particular topic, but I'm sure somewhere it will be beginning to this particular journey that may be a very long and enjoyable. These are, though the characteristics of question, they are equally important for research process. When we are thinking about, we are talking about the selection of the research topic, I'm sure we will talk about these, though in different contexts, issues involved in the process, like where they are relevant, whether we can avoid ambiguity, whether we can clearly state what we aim to do and how we are going to do, whether we will be comprehensive, whether we will use vocabulary that is common. I'm sure some of you will get reminded of Vasudh here, the vocabulary that is common, targeting the audience or the readers that we are having in mind. These answers will be very important, I believe, to help us make this journey very smooth. I'm sure some of us will get reminded of ourselves, those who have already completed their research projects or those who are in between and those who are planning to start one. Many a times, the past experiences of the researchers may stumble us, may stop us from thinking afresh, because it's like a blind journey. It's like a journey that may not have some direction or may not have any end within our catchment. So it's like a blind journey, but believe me, this blind journey will be turn out to be a very fruitful journey for many of us. I don't want to put you in the dilemma whether to start the journey or not. This slide just here appears here to make you aware that maybe this is also one side of the research process. Many times, if we are not clear about what we want to do when we start our research, we may come across certain questions. For example, why I'm planning for a research? I'm planning research because I want to check on the learning, or I want to expand the explanations, or maybe I want to reflect, or maybe I want to improve attention or encourage active learning. Maybe, whatever the purpose be, at times it may address more than one objectives, or it is possible that somebody will come over with or will add many dimension to this, because this cannot be exhaustive kind of document which can I request the participants to stop annotating? Pratishruti, please don't allow others to annotate because they are putting their cursors on the screen. So many a times we will experience that you can add your own points to this design, and there is no sacred number like 6 or 8 or 5. For you, it may be multi-targeted kind of exploration. But rest sure that when you will start, you will have to have some model. And for that process, that start, that catalyst, you can use this design. But you are free to add different dimension to this process if you wish to. If some of you have undergone the research already, you will understand what this picture suggests. I'm sure I don't claim that this is the unique picture that I am sharing in this presentation. You might have come across this picture in many contexts, but why I'm using this here? I feel that our research project is nothing but making up the gaps. And for that, it is very important to identify the gaps first. When I am talking about identification of gap, I'm referring to the process which we may call review of literature, or in introduction chapter when we state the reasons why we are undertaking some project. So we are heading towards this slide. We are planning to make up some gaps. So in order to understand where the gaps are, a very exhaustive literary review is necessary, and I'm sure you will understand that this making up of gap may be required at occasions, at different occasions and at different stages, and more particularly when you are drawing your inferences, then you will be banking upon the gaps only. And I'm sure the exhaustiveness of this identification of gaps will lead you towards a successful project in future. Very important question at this juncture would be, why do I need to do research? I'm showing this slide purposefully after that finding gap kind of image, because once we are clear about our process, then these questions would be answered very easily. And because we know the purpose, we will be more focused about the activity, more focused about the selection, and would be avoiding the maybe diversion in the process. At this moment, I would like to ask all whether I am fully or comfortably audible or not. Am I audible to all? Am
yes,
I
sir.
Audible?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. You are audible.
Thank you. Thank you very much. So when we are talking about the gaps, when we are talking about the research, one may think, when they have a question in mind, is finding a gap is the only purpose of research? This is a very valid question at this moment, because this cannot be the only purpose of our research. So we will go back to slide 3 again, when we have stated 6 to 7 maybe focus points where the purpose of research were discussed, and we can go on adding to that particular image if required based on our experiences of finding gaps in that process. All of a sudden we are in some situation where a lot of rain and some disruption in the traffic or the road has taken place. I'm sure many of us have come across such situation. At least those who are commuting frequently on the road in the rainy season, they might have come across this situation. But have you ever thought of converting this situation into a research? Very interestingly, you would surprise that even such natural situation may offer you a chance if you are able to find the gaps in research. You find some points and focus and purpose of research. So no situation is disqualifier for any researcher to proceed for the project. Only the thing is that the researcher should be clear about what a researcher wish to go, where researcher wish to go, what that researcher wish to explore, and how that researcher is planning to document that exploration into a piece of writing, which may be turn out to be research, a piece of research in the end. Now, since this is post-lunch session, I'm a little skeptic about the capacity of the presenter like me to keep you engaged in this session for long. And forgive me if I am undermining your capacity to be good and patient listener for a long duration. I would like you to be collaborative and participative in the way. At this, when I said that this natural kind of situation can be converted into possibly or maybe probable topic for research, if you agree with me, then you can write in chat box that you are, oh yes, I agree with you, or you are at least free at all to say that, oh no, we don't agree with you, because we are in very very informal kind of setup here. You are free to express your views and comment accordingly in the chat box. Yes, I'm sure you have freedom to choose whether you want to comment or not, but your participation would encourage me to go further with a lot of elaborations in future. Again, somebody is annotating on the screen. Please, Pratish Rukun, ask the participants to avoid this.
Participants, please stop using your stylus and kindly let the speaker speak without any kind of hassles. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Pratish Rukun. Now, when we are talking about research, we may have some ideas about what research may mean. For some, it is a journey. It is exploration. It is a kind of a review. It is a kind of gap-finding exercise. So I want you yourself to think about this research project, because this is an online event. So there are certain limitations about the participation and collaborative exercises and so on and so forth. So though I would like to introduce some collaborative exercise in between, I understand the limitation of such activities in this online mode. But at the same time, those who can use these tools, can I request Pratish Rukun to paste link in the chat box where there are two links very precisely. One link is about Google Doc, where the participants can add what they wish to ask me or they wish to add to my presentation, some clarifications, some additions. And second link is about Whiteboard, where they can contribute to the full picture when at the end we will look at this whiteboard and see the collaborative exercise and result of that collaborative exercise. Again, I'm sure. About what the research is. Maybe for some, this is discovery. For some, this is maybe evaluation of something. For some, this is survey of what is known and what is the opinion to examination, to locate and identify. So there are many possibilities. And I'm sure this is not exhaustive design. You can add many more dimensions to this particular exercise and come up with the fantastic ideas. When we are talking about research, we will be traveling from one domain to another, one terrain to another, because we all know that research cannot be isolated activity. Research cannot maybe very very scope specific kind of activity. At times, it may be interdisciplinary. It may be multidisciplinary. Even in literature, this can cover so many aspects of studies. And to give you some idea about that, this slide will help you in that way. Because if you are in search of some topic or a problem, what are some qualifiers for this particular selection process? That this problem should be interesting to you first. When I say you as a researcher, because if you are involved fully in the process, then that outcome of this particular process, which is known as some draft or some report or some theory or some dissertation or some thesis, that will be a very interesting piece for others to read, the readers to read. So it should be interesting to you first, and it should have some practical value for the users. I have used the word stakeholders. Forgive me for that, because this is not a domain specific word. Stakeholders means the users, the readers, the society, researchers who will do research survey prior to their research projects. They should be able to involve your work in that particular survey and those who practice these exercises. It should not be over research. What do I mean when I said that the problem or your research topic should not be over research? There are certain issues which are very popular. When I say popular, quote unquote, I mean very easy to find, very easy to explore, and slightly here and there, and the result is fantastic. Being serious, genuine researcher, we should avoid this over researching areas, terrain. Of course, I understand. In order to understand what is over research, you need some systematic survey and exploration, which is a very important part of the literary review. I'm sure this survey will give you some idea about what are the issues which are over research or which are under research. One of my friend, while referring to this particular area and period of comparison and study and exploration, came up with a very fantastic idea. And she is thinking about having KMS, Knowledge Management System, where she has something in mind, like she will offer some website or some solution of platform, such as platform based on this LMS, KMS, where the scholars would be able to find out the things which are already done. Maybe in a kind of, it would be a kind of consortium. See, this is very, very premature to say anything on this. But of course, I understand that this way, the efforts of the scholar to review literature, whether one particular topic is over research or under research or qualify to make some project, like, so this can be very fantastic exercise in that direction. And I'm sure many are waiting for such attempts. And as a research scholar, you will get benefit out of that. But the gist of this particular discussion is, at this juncture, we have to understand first what is done, already done, where we are planning, where we are proposed to start. So it will save us from future complications if we are meticulous and systematic on this. And see, next point is equally valid. Maybe you have a very fantastic plan of research in your mind, but how about manageability of that particular project? Is it timely management? It is timely managed. It is viewed possible that the whatever we have in mind can be finished in a stipulated period of time, where we can bring out the result, end product of this research, maybe a form of report, maybe a form of analysis, maybe a form of funding, or maybe a kind of thesis. Is it manageable? Here, I'm sure you will get reminded of three unities, the dramatists and the theoretician on dramaturgy, they talked about three unities, unity of time, unity of action. I'm sure all three unities are not important in this or not suitable for our discussion. But certainly unity of action and unity of time can be very good qualifiers to decide upon whether we are on right track or whether we are undergoing for the right purpose and in the right direction or not. So this understanding of whether we are planning a realistic kind of project is very important. And this is last one. There should not be any legal or moral obstacle. For example, I'm trying to plan some research project which is beneficial to the society in general. But who will decide what is beneficial to the society in large? So there should not be any element, or there should not be any issue which may attract you towards the legal and moral obstacles. So as a researcher, you need to be aware about this this particular. Again, I would like to say, add that this is not exhaustive list. There may be n number of characteristics of good research, but given the limitation that we are working upon, I think this is my take, and you are free to add to these limitations if required. There are different research designs. As students of literature, we would be focusing on exploratory and descriptive. Again, in some rare cases, experimental research is also possible, but I'm not sure whether we can undertake diagnostic research in our chosen area. So we will be mainly focusing on these three: explorative, descriptive, and experimental. I'm sure you will understand that any research is a product of some reading. Any research is a product of some survey. Any research is a product of some meticulous analysis. And from this slide onwards, you will get to know about some practical kind of issues relating with this reading. Because what reading will give you, we have already discussed and shared this with you. Reading will give us some idea about what is already done. It will give us some ideas, even though some issues are already discussed and dealt with other earlier researchers. Some exhaustive reading may offer us some idea as to what new can be done out of that already done. So for that, your analytical capacity, critical thinking will play a very important role in this particular phase of your research. Because if you are sure about, if you are very well acquainted with what is already done by the earlier researcher, you will try to avoid the over or maybe repetition. You will try to avoid over research kind of stage. And this reading will help you to broaden your perspective and will help you in setting yourself in context. It will also help you to build up your arguments based on the research already done, and that may maybe help you in the process in the longer run. This is very important activity. And here in this particular slide, I'm trying to expose you to this very initial stage of research, where you are thinking about what to do. For example, you may have, or we have some very hazy kind of ideas about topic in our mind. Hazy kind of some assumptions like this may be a good topic for research, or this may be good author to pursue, or maybe like something like that. But when you are on this journey, you will understand that the reading will help you to come upon or focus upon the things which are required to be undertaken in this particular process. And more exposed you are to these various areas, I'm sure you will be able to focus and choose very appropriate title in the process. And for that, this wide and exhaustive reading is very important. I'm not going to read all four, because I'm sure you will be able to understand what I mean to say. I would like your focus upon the last point, where I'm talking about the expectations of the readers from the report or thesis or a dissertation or maybe analysis or a survey result and all. So this advanced idea about who the readers are and what they would like to read from you will help you to keep focus on the writing process or research process. So having this point in mind may help us in the long run to focus on our process. So apart from these four, the fifth one, you will need a reader, and you will need the understanding about the expectations of the readers, and that will help you to be on, to keep focus on your research project. Because we are, I'm assuming that most of us are researchers in the field of humanities, literature, particularly, and I don't want to ignore those who are here in this particular session out of the interest with the multidisciplinary approach and interdisciplinary approach. I do respect their choice. But since majority of the listeners are from the humanity background, I would be referring to the cases which are mostly applicable to the field of humanities literature. Here in this slide, there are four issues that I would discuss. First is the volume of literature. Now, when we are talking about focus of our literature, one has to understand first, one has to have clear idea about, or maybe fair idea about the area, terrain that one wish to explore. And I'm sure while preparing for this particular stage, you have come across so many varied areas which are mingling into each other, cross mingling into each other, and they are separate at times. For example, there is a possibility that some of you may go for critical aspects of some writer or some age or some genre, right? So in this way, you will try to amalgamate 3, 4, 5 panes, P-A-N-E, panes, into each other. But it would be very interesting to understand first the scope that we are trying to address. The variety of literature that we have, the scope, or maybe the choices we may have. Again, very important constraint would be the boundaries. If we don't limit our scope or our study, as we have already discussed in a few slides back, about the scope and the area of our research, we won't be able to focus upon our research, and that would not be a manageable project in the end. So we have to understand the limitation of our project or limitation of our research. And we have to be very clear about this at the beginning only to avoid complications in the future. And this is very common, but less talked about, that we have to be very clear about the arguments which are conflicting. For example, your topic, your area of research is something that is particularly your focus and your case specific. So you need not talk about certain issues which are greatly explored and they are still open for the debate and discussion. So you won't be able to contribute anything concrete to this particular stock of knowledge which is already available. And if there is no value addition to what is already known, then your attempt to explore this will be futile. And as a researcher, one has to be very careful about avoiding such situations and issues while choosing a focus for our research. Pratishruti.
Yes, sir.
Can we ask participants at this juncture if everything is okay for them or somebody wish to add or ask something?
Sir, we can, I mean, you may continue. We can have a question answer session at the end of your presentation if you permit.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay. Thank you.
Or else I request the participants, in case they have got any kind of doubts, they can type it in the chat box. I will communicate it to sir.
Thank you, Pratishruti.
My pleasure, sir.
And my flow is okay, Pratishruti?
Yes, sir. Yes, absolutely.
Continuing what actually some of you may start asking, why I'm focusing more on reading. Because we all are in the age of technology and we all believe in the instant 2 minutes Maggie model. And nowadays, so many things are available at the fingertips that we tend to undermine this very basic exercise in the research process. So deliberately, I'm maybe focusing on this particular exercise, which is very vital. And if it is not undertaken appropriately at the beginning, we may not get a very important experience in our research project. And that I don't want you to miss. So please don't undermine the importance of reading activity in the age of technology. And it is equally important as it was in earlier days. I have tried to divide this reading exercise with the focus shifting from one stage to second stage to third. I'm sure this is not all inclusive model and you may come across fantastic ideas in addition to this model. But for me, reading can be divided and is important at all three stages of research. At the beginning, when you propose to initiate some journey or project of research, and in between, during the research and after your research too. How do I classify this reading exercise in three different sections, three stages? And I'm sure you will understand by now that I'm covering almost all the stages of research in these three divisions. So I'm talking about pre-project reading. I'm talking about during project reading. I'm talking about post-project reading. So first three points that I wish to make at the beginning of the project or a process or research proposal, I want you to check. It is very important for us to check what earlier researchers have done in the area of our choice. And then only after exhaustive reading and analysis, we will be able to focus upon our ideas. And when we will focus upon our ideas, we'll be able to explore the context of our work. And more clear about our exploration we are, more it will reflect in the process when you are talking about during the research. What is the importance of reading exercise in the research during research project? During the research project, it will help us to keep our interest and keep us up to date. because I believe the research is the process of around 5 years. Around 5 years, it's not a sacred number. Some may finish this project within 3 years of time. Some may take, good researcher will take, or may take some longer period one. So that depends on the kind of work that you have, you are undertaking, the kind of expectations you have from that process. So this will be varied according to the requirement and stages of your research. And why it is important to read between, during the research project, it is also, that would be a very good source of our data. That would be very good source of our data. So initially 3 stages at the beginning and during the research. But for, according to me, research, reading is important post research too. Because how we are going to how post research reading is will help us in understanding of our work. It will help us in the analysis of the impact of our project, our findings, our analysis, our survey, our figures on the earlier work done so far, and that can be a very, very interesting area of research again. To analyze the impact of our research on the earlier known, quote unquote, known things, and that would be very interesting addition to that learning. What is important? Why post reading, post research is important? Because it will offer some good ideas for the future project participants. You can develop your, we can develop our own ideas for the further projects based on the earlier surveys or earlier project reports. So for me, this reading is important at these 3 different stages, which covers almost all stages of research. And I'm sure I'm trying to suggest you that reading is an indispensable part of our research project, irrespective of the stage we are in. Irrespective of stage we are in, whether we are budding scholars, it is important. Whether we are ongoing scholars, it is important. Whether you are, sorry to use this cross-lingual word, banchuke quote-unquote scholars, it is reading. I don't.
Hello, sir. Joshi, sir.
Please unmute yourself, Vivek, sir. Hello, Pratishruti.
Yes.
Am I audible?
You were not audible, actually, sir.
Now, am I audible?
Yes.
And my screen is also visible?
Sir, your screen is not visible, actually. Right now it is visible. Thank you.
What may be the issue? Some connectivity?
Maybe so.
Okay.
So that's fine. I mean, we are quite brave enough to conglomerate in this era of technology wherein hitches are there.
Okay.
Yes. Please continue.
So my screen is visible now?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Give me a second and I'll get back. Can you see the strategy now? Basic reading strategies? Right.
Yes, sir, we can.
Okay. And sorry, participants, for this technical issue from my side, maybe.
Sir, can you do a little bit of a recap from the last slide, the last lines that you were speaking?
This one?
Yes, sir. Maybe, I mean, you were somewhere, Banchuke scholars, that how even for Banchuke scholars, the reading is very necessary, very pivotal. From there, you can start.
So, I were referring to this eight kind of point that my slide contains. Hello, am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So I were about to say that this reading is very vital and important for all sorts of scholars, irrespective of their status. I said that this is important for the new budding scholar who is about to start his journey, or researcher as a researcher, or the ones who have already explored something, they are on some about some project, and they are in between some research project. It is important to them. And it is also important to quote-unquote Banchuke type of scholars who have already contributed substantially to the field of knowledge, yet they are planning to add something more. That I wanted to make point upon. So I hope I am clear now.
Yes, sir. Please continue, sir.
Right. And sorry for using that multilingual term like Banchuke.
That's interesting, sir. Thank you.
Okay. Now, then I said that I won't be on this. I have already covered this discussion in the slide. So I will moving on the next slide. Here, we are talking about what are the, I would like to disclaim that this is not exhaustive or exclusive kind of strategies that I would be talking about. Majority of the things would be based upon my experience as a researcher first. And again, some sort of experience as a supervisor in this particular time frame. And I don't want to claim that this is the only strategy that will lead you to the success. Maybe this can be customized accordingly. This can be personalized accordingly. Many things can be added to this particular perspective. Now, we are talking about what can be strategies for reading. As we have discussed in the previous slide, that in this age of technology, all or many things are available at the fingertips. But very important is to understand what we are looking for. What we are looking for. For example, I have a fantastic library and specialized resources and consortia. But if in the want of clear understanding of what I'm searching for, that infrastructure or maybe investment would be futile exercise. So I'm trying to make you aware of this particular facts, and this would be very important stage of exercise where at the beginning, if you are sure about these issues, you will save yourself from the complications later stage of your research. For example, I'm talking about computer assisted learning. I'm talking about taking assistance of consortia. I'm talking about taking the help of nowadays in Indian scenario, it is very helpful to search issues or of topics or the areas we are planning to start research about when we will visit some Rishod Ganga or Shod Sindhu kind of consortia, or there are other professional websites which offer you this information at fingertips. But I wish to make you aware about the limitations of this sites also, because as far as the authenticity of the content is concerned, we have to be very judicious while using this as a data for our research purpose. So our discretion is required in the usage of this kind of data. Here in this slide, I'm sorry for this typo. It's just very small. I'm sure many of you would be able to read and make sense out of this. But if you don't, I'll share this presentation with Pratishruti, and she will be able to share this further to one who wish to have the copy about. So I'm here in this particular list, I'm talking about what can be the various kind of types of reading areas, like some reports or popular media like films, or maybe some computer based materials. Then I'm also talking about the important division like the primary sources, secondary sources, tertiary sources, e-sources, which are very common nowadays. I'm also talking about the
edited documents and literature review. I'm talking about methodological and confessional writing. So I'm talking about this because this may be a source of good information to you. Because if you want to start anything that is novel or maybe not very explored, quote unquote, you may get help from this particular varied kind of types, quote unquote, again. As we are researchers, and as we are researchers, I don't want to be prescriptive, but these are two very important things before we start doing anything regarding our project or maybe some topic that we are in mind. It is important to read about authoritative kind of people only, and it is very important to read founding thinkers because that will help you in a way to make your ground more clear, and maybe that understanding will help you to maybe explore what you wish to very methodically, and it may stimulate your thinking process, and that may help you in refinement of your project. Many times the supervisors suggest scholars to prepare a list of keywords of their research project, or they ask their scholars to prepare a list of journals with the latest kind of addition to the or latest issues and understanding of the development or happenings around their chosen area of research. And with the I'm not against the technology, but with the spurge of this online kind of presence of these resources, we may tend to undermine the importance of this recording of the resources is concerned. But I'm sure your scholars and your research supervisors won't let you ignore this particular important phase of research, because data keeping of this sort of resources will help you to keep track of your references and your material for a long time, and that particular document will be helpful to you in tracking the research of your chosen area. I'm sure you have heard name of Masson. Came up with a fantastic publication in the year 1996, and he's trying to discuss mainly about some qualitative projects, where he is suggesting us to focus on some questions in order to help us track our projects. And out of five questions, the last one is my favorite. I'm sure you have come across his model earlier, and I would share my reason why I like this fifth question in the model, Masson's model of focusing. Should I read this four earlier stated focus in maybe I'll refer them personally. What is the nature of our phenomena, entities, or social reality? Are you interested in social actor? Like. What might represent knowledge or evidence of the entities? Like, what topic or broad substantive area in the research concerned with? What would be the generic label with your research for your research? Sorry,
What is the intellectual puzzle? What do I wish to explain? These are very basic questions though, but they will help us focus upon our project. And my favorite is last one. What is the purpose of my research? What I am doing for it? See, why I like this? Because it is equally important to understand my process before I wish to call that is a project, my project. So first I need to understand what is the purpose of my research, why I am doing this. And then the second very important addenda to this is what I'm doing to make it my project, which is substantial in nature. What I'm doing it for, what is the purpose and why I'm doing this. So this will help us in tracking our project process. This will help us in keeping ourselves focused. No elaboration is required about this because we all are students. So we understand the importance of catalogs, database, then reviews, dictionaries, encyclopedias, and other shells. These are some soft links which will help you in exploring the issues. But I'm sure I don't want to claim it to be exhaustive because many more links are possible, and we can add our own links to this particular data to make it more wider and more inclusive. I'm sure we all, or some of us, have heard name of Rountree, who again come up with a fantastic publication in 1991. He talked about SQ3R. Now, this strategy that he talks about, or the writer talks about, is about 3 R's plus survey and question. This is why I'm referring this, because in order to keep ourselves focused, pointed, we need to follow this SQ and 3R strategy. Though it is said that this is flexible strategy, of course, I'm going to talk about SQ4R also, but this will be in the next phase. So what is SQ3R? It's survey to get general drift of the material, then question to meet your expectation. Then R1 is to read carefully, R2 to recite, to recall the main points, and R3 to review, check how well you have recalled by going back to the text. I'm sure some of the seasoned research scholars have come across this model, but I would like to introduce this model to the budding scholars who are planning to start or initiate on some research project. And during their project and journey, they would require to focus on this SQ3R strategies to keep themselves engaged and relevant. Now, after this, I'm going to talk about SQ4R. So in addition to what Rountree has said, Walter and Sigbert in 1903 came up with addition, fourth R, to this model. And what is that fourth R? These authors are talking about relating what we have read, recited, and reviewed. So they came up with a fourth R besides survey, question, SQ, and first reading, second recite, third review. They have come up with a fourth R that is related. This is high order thinking skill. And they are talking about this addition to the earlier model of 3R, and fourth R is of relation, relating earlier one with the present one. So I'm sure you will understand the quality and focus of your research in this way. Here I'm talking about recording of our reading. And I am sure you will understand the importance of this activity because more you are aware about this process, the meticulity of the earlier process will be defined on this, because your seriousness in reading, seriousness in comprehension,
seriousness in recalling, reciting, and relating will reflect in your writing, recording notices. So this will be very important. I'm sure those who are seasoned scholar, they will have a feeling like, okay, repeating the things like, but forgive me for this repetition. I'm aiming at those who are about to start the research projects. I'm aiming at those who are in some projects. They have started somewhere and now they are undergoing some research project. And for the sake of their benefit, I'm referring to these particular slides. I'm trying to discuss these issues because they will help these research scholars in the long run. So here in this slide, I'm trying to discuss the importance of recording of our understanding. And in this slide particularly, I'm talking about importance of the keeping of the record keeping of what we are reading. Some of you may understand this as a parenthetical interest exercise where we are quoting the texts and the contexts. So I'm talking in the different maybe diction maybe, but I'm referring to the same exercise, keeping record of all the sources that we are using, keeping record of all the texts, the books or the sources we are using for research work. And that will help us in at different stages differently, but certainly this record keeping will make our job little comfortable rest upon, because this will be continuously ongoing activity, and you will have maybe an opportunity to review this particular text frequently to help you prepare your parenthetical entries in the latter stages when you will start recording your research or your maybe findings. Here I'm talking about what would be the content of my proposal for the thesis or project proposal. Here I'm talking about, yes, I have adapted this from Hart, coined in 1998 publication, where this model was discussed. There are four important quadrants of your report or maybe your proposal. They are in form of maybe what are your key sources, what are the key theories you will bank upon, what is the epistemological and ontological grounds for the discipline, and what are the major issues you are trying to address. These four quadrants will help you prepare this part where you will prepare a background for your proposal. You will say in precise what are the key sources you are using, what are the key theories you will bank upon, then epistemological and ontological ground, and then major issues that you wish to focus upon. These are very common yet very special kind of hurdles, stumbling blocks in the process of research. Many times some of us at least have faced these issues like, oh, I want to do certain research, but there is nothing that I can bank upon, like, or other in extreme situation, hey, there are too many things to include in the chosen area where I wish to undergo. Or there is nothing new possible in the chosen area. What to do then? And very important question, how many references do I need to make my research substantial? I'm sure the answers would not be ready-made to this. But as we are meticulous in our review of literature, we will understand that the issues we are about to explore are important, if they are important, then our review of literature will be very important milestone whether to decide whether we are focusing on the right maybe kind of proposal or not. Because if, as we have already discussed in the earlier slides, if it is over research, there is no point in going for that. If it is under research, then maybe the chances are you may not have sufficient amount of review literature or maybe criticism or maybe content available for the review of literature. But that won't disqualify that chosen area from exploration. So that would be individual discretion. But this is not exhaustive list. Many innovative scholars may come across, or they will be adding more excuses to this list, and they will make this list very comprehensive in that way. But these are the four major kind of issues which I thought of, and then I share this with you. Of course, I understand that we may not be able to conduct this exercise in this online format, but if possible, then you can start exercise on your own after this session, and you can have your reflection on this particular three questions: why to research, what to research, and when to research. I'm sure there is no prescriptive model of answers for these questions. These are open-ended questions, and you can come up with your own kind of answers. And if you wish to share this, we will give you the link for such share. I'm sure Pratishruti has already shared this link in the WhatsApp, this chat box of the Zoom presentation format. Pratishruti, yes, have you posted that link over there?
Yes, sir, I have.
So those who wish to contribute, they can. In the both, if they are comfortable with doc, they can share their views in doc form. If they are comfortable with whiteboard, they can go for that choice. So both the links are already shared by Pratishruti. Because I understand that such activities cannot be organized in such form of webinars, but they are there for the participants, those who wish to think about this issue even after the completion of this webinar and continue to explore the possibilities. Pratishruti, how much time I have for?
So you may continue. I mean, we have time till 4 o'clock, in the sense, including question answer session. So it's up to you, sir.
It's almost hour has started, right?
Yes, sir. It has. It is.
Am I testing the patient audience now?
Not at all, sir. So research is serious, sir. So please continue, sir.
Because I am always skeptic about the patience of the participants, so I need to be very careful about that. Thank you, Pratishruti. Now, after having discussed so many things, some of you might have started futility of this session, because the title of this presentation says that it starts with first WH, no? How to select some topic for studies, research in English literature. And I haven't spoke anything about that title. But friends, I'm sure you will agree with me that prescription of any sort would not help us in the long run. It is, I believe that exploration or the research is our personal kind of journey. And we ourselves are the driving force in this particular process. And any prescription for that matter would mar the result of that process. And I'm sure the exploration that our journey will have in the end, or the value addition that we'll have in the end, will benefit us personally, professionally, and we will enjoy that process. But I'm sure the inputs that I'm giving will help in a way, maybe in a minute kind of form, and I would be happy if they are helpful to you in this way. Here in this particular area now, I am taking you for the reflection or self-exploration. Like, for example, if I am a scholar, I must understand, I must ask one question to me only. For example, how the idea comes
for the research project. What is the source of such ideas? For example, ABC, I don't want to name anybody, but if Abdul Shamim has to start something, how does, what is the process? Or Aparna Pandey wants to do something. Sorry if I'm naming these participants without their consent. I'm sure they won't mind, do they? Would they mind if I name some participants?
Aparna Pandey and Abdul Shamim, you can respond to sir directly. He wants you to respond.
Or otherwise, those who wish to respond, they can voluntarily ask me. I will ask, call them. In the want of names, anybody can volunteer, and then I can call that name and we'll have some dialogue. If organizers allow us to do though. Nobody?
Yes, sir. Organizers, they do allow you to talk to anyone. For example, Sir Azhar Nazir, he wants you to call his name and you can talk to him.
So, if I can use first name of Mr. Azhar, am I using right? Mr. Azhar?
Azhar, you can unmute your mic and talk to sir. Mr. Azhar?
Yes, sir. Sir, you can take my name. Yes, sir.
Okay. So thank you, Azhar, for allowing me to take your name. Our topic of discussion is how, what prompts us for a topic of research? If you are a researcher, let me know. Can I ask you one question? Are you a researcher or are you planning a research? A project, or you have already completed some research project? What is actually, where you are actually?
No, sir, I am in my BA honors program, sir, actually.
Okay, you are in BA honors program. So congratulations, yes, Azhar, for choosing to be in this particular session. And
thank you, sir.
I welcome you to this. And I have a question to you. What or where do you search for your research topics?
Sir, actually, I have not started yet that question, sir.
Okay. Theek hai. Thank you, Azhar, for being with us.
Thank you, sir.
Now you can mute yourself.
Sir? Yeah. Joshi, sir.
Yes.
Sir, even Abdul Shamim and Mr. Ravi Shankar and Kalpana Gawande, even they would like to
dialogue with you. They all can unmute themselves. I will talk to them all.
Yes.
Okay, sir. I am Abdul Shamim, sir.
So, dear participants, welcome to this session, and I hope you are enjoying this.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, wherever you will speak, you will introduce yourself, your name, and your context, where you are working, and your stage of research, whether you are a researcher, seasoned researcher, you have already completed some projects and planning for future projects, or whether you are about to some project and like that. Okay. So one question is, where do you go to search your ideas for research project? Anybody can answer this question by naming and sharing the context.
Good afternoon to all of you. I am Abdul Shamim, Assistant Professor of English at Renuka College, Besa Nagpur. I am a research scholar and presently I am pursuing my doctoral research on multiculturalism. I have searched that topic on Shodh Ganga.
Okay.
That how many research scholars have already done research work on multiculturalism on Rohinton Mystery. After that, I have decided that I am going to do my research.
Okay. Shodh Ganga, you said. You got idea about research project on Shodh Ganga, right?
Yes, sir.
Thank you. Is there anybody who would like to answer this question?
Hello, sir. I'm Ravi Shankar from Bengaluru. I'm working as a lecturer.
Okay.
In a PU college. I'm willing to take up a research project in the near future.
Okay.
I'm interested in the field of translation. So okay. I keep reading books. I thought after reading books frequently, I think I may get an idea as to in which field I can do research. Okay. That is what I thought. And the second thing is that I keep talking to people who have done research and who have been doing, some people, not too many, few people, I keep talking to them, chat with them, just try to get some ideas from them and try to know more about how to go about with that and how to choose and everything.
Thank you, Ravi Shankar. I hope you are enjoying this presentation.
Yeah, yeah. Definitely.
And you are getting something out of this.
Definitely, sir. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Ravi Shankar, for being with us. Who else is there to contribute to this? Hello? Hello?
Kalpana Gavande, would you like to respond? Mrs. Kalpana Gavande?
Yes, please go ahead. Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Mrs. Kalpana Gavande from Akola, Maharashtra. I'm a school teacher in School of Scholars, Kolkata, Akola. I have not done any research, but planning for the research. So I think this webinar is definitely helpful for me. So first of all, I will be thankful to INET for organizing such a wonderful and informative session for us. Thank you, sir.
Are you done? Kalpana ji?
Yes, sir.
Over?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So you are planning for research. Ravi Shankar has started his project on translation. And Arif is maybe the ongoing, his project is ongoing. And he has searched for ideas on Shodhganga, right? Am I making any mistake? No? Okay. So based on this, we will have some idea about there is some participant with unmuted kind of status. Please mute yourself now. Now, so right. So this very brief interaction with these four energetic and bright minds, we got an idea about what are the sources of inspiration and ideas for the research project, like. The consortia like Shodhganga may offer you some kind of help, or talking to the experts or reading books related with your area of research would help you bring some ideas for your project. And this way, this can be a very good exercise and where you go. But probably you have many more. You may have very different kind of aspects and sources for your ideas. And for that, you need to understand that ideas are present everywhere. We have to look for them. Because as Ravi Shankar has suggested, we read books for the ideas, but we are not sure which book will give us which idea. So we need to keep going this exercise of reading book, keep going as we need to keep talking to the people to get ideas of the discussion. So it won't be kind of exhaustive exercise that, okay, one person will give you one idea. Maybe an idea will come any occasion, any time. So we need to be in the receptive mode always. Thank you, Ravi Shankar. Thank you, Ravi Shankar, for your inputs. Thank you, Kalpana Tai, for your inputs and all participants. I'm happy about the person, the participant who is in the BA course and he chose to be here. And I'm happy that he has started his journey, or the participant has started his journey of this Shodh Yatra, if I can use that word again, in the different lingua, and journey towards the research. And I congratulate him for his selection. I'm sure my second point is related with Ravi Shankar's idea, source of idea, where I'm talking about the experiences of practical problems in the field, they are either in the books or either they are either with the people. I don't want to touch this area today. Just I will give some brushing references to this, because we are into, majority of us would be into exploratory research or studies, and they will be further classified into literature search or experience survey, and again reclassified into focus group and analysis of selected case or works. This need another session or one more session for the discussion, and I am forced to skip this slide with these brushing references. This is very important. Again, this is exploratory and reflective exercise, where again you will have an occasion to reflect upon your own views and your own positions in the sheet, Google Doc, or maybe on the whiteboard, the links provided provided to you. Rest assured that you can use these particular sheets till the till tomorrow or day after tomorrow. I will close this after 14th of this month. I will allow you all to contribute for two more days after this particular session is over. So these three questions: how did you prepare yourself for research? What was the preparation? What do you think one should prepare for research? How one should prepare for research? And what are your equipments, like a toolkit? What do you need to help yourself in the process of research? What are your recipe? What are your recipes for that? And very important third question: what would you do after the research? I hope you will understand that these three questions cover this pre, during, and post research kind of stages. I hope this reflective exercise will help you in getting understanding about the seriousness and diversity of this particular exercise. Some of you might have come across this list by Hussey Anderson, 1997. There are some reasons why we undergo research. This is available with Pratishruti at request. And this is my source list. I planned this session for 90 minutes, and I am sure that was engaging lecture to you. We could discuss some ideas. I could get some ideas from the participants in the discussion. And if at all some queries are unresolved, this is my email ID where you can write to me your feedback and your suggestions. This is my phone number. You can call me for any discussion about this issue or any kind of other issues related to the research, if you feel comfortable. Thank you very much, organizers, Sri Ramdev Baba College of Engineering and Management, Nagpur, and INET Association of English Teachers, for giving me this opportunity to share my views with these young, talented, bright minds oriented towards research. Thank you all, and I wish you all the best in your research journey. Thank you all once again.
So thank you very much. You are not supposed to leave right now. Hello?
Yes, I am here.
Yeah, and I request all the participants also to stay back. And research is just like a blind date, as I told with in the beginning, that you don't know what you want to do, what you want to say, what you want to write. But yes, you know that there is a vast knowledge, there is vast bank of knowledge in front of you, which is infinite, and you just need to tap that which area you want to focus upon. And probably we have found quite some guiding with sir's hello, am I audible?
Yes.
Yeah. With Sir's deliberation, we have found some idea that how we can start with our research, how to choose a research topic. So I invite the participants to come up with their questions. Sir, we have participants from across the world, from Saudi Arabia, from Mexico, from Belarus as well, apart from Imphal, Kerala, Hyderabad, quite a number of cities and places in Maharashtra. So I invite the participants to ask their questions, if they have got any related to research, related to choosing their topic, any kind of a hitch that they are facing, even while submitting their proposal. So you can go ahead and ask your questions to sir. For asking your questions, you may unmute your mic and ask the question.
Mohammed Ukai has raised hand.
Yes, Mohammed Ukai, you can go ahead.
Okay, I can say good morning because it's still morning here in Morocco.
Yes, please.
And good afternoon there in India. Thank you very much for the initiative. Really, I appreciate the presentation. I'd like to thank the presenter for his interesting presentation and for all your effort to make it a success. I would like to have a question. I'm in the beginning of my research and I'm researching in literature, and I would like to work on literature in relationship to eco-criticism. My question, again, I mean, in terms of methodology, can he recommend some books that can help us elaborate on our methodology in literary culture studies, because most of the researchers are books are in social sciences. And thank you.
Thank you, Mohammed, for your query regarding the prescription of some research method books as far as literature is concerned. It is difficult to prescribe one book or so. We can have a list of this resource bank, resource books. I will hand over this list to Pratishruti, and Pratishruti will be able to share this list further to you.
Thank you.
Mohammed Ukai, you can mail me, and I will mail the list to you. You can just mail me. I guess you have my mail address. It's there,
sure,
in the flyer,
sure.
Right?
Yeah.
So you can mail me with your query, and I would be able to reply you.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
List of books.
Thank you very much.
Yes. Anyone else would like to come in?
Hello,
and,
ma'am.
Yes, Mr. Kamri, you can go ahead.
Yeah, just the session was very wonderful, and the sir gave us very good information regarding the research and research methodology rather. Okay, but I'd like to ask him a question. Can the articles published in the newspaper be mentioned in literature review? Hello, ma'am.
Yeah.
Can the articles published in the newspaper be mentioned in literature review?
Sir, question to you.
Yes, why not? Because if you remember, I have talked about selection of this particular literature where we are forming our maybe report or maybe some project. And nowadays, it is very important to understand the importance of this media, print media particularly, because with the spread of technology, many are coming up with the editions like digital edition and the print edition. So there is nothing wrong in maybe quoting these sources in your research. The context and content will decide to what extent you will use. But you won't find the parenthetical entry style of quoting this newspaper items or articles in that. But MLA style sheet of edition 5 onwards, you will have the format of quoting newspaper kind of articles in the reference style sheet. So there is nothing harm in doing that.
Okay, thank you very much.
Thank you, Mr. Kamre. Anybody else would like to ask his or her query to sir? I know it's very difficult at times when it comes to research to come up with query. After listening to you, probably the churning of thought process will start in quite a number of participants, and then only they'll be able to formulate their questions once they start working upon. And our association is going to continue. Participants, you can send in your queries to my mail ID, and I can just send it across to Joshi sir. So those queries can also be answered.
Ma'am, I'd like to ask something.
Yes, go ahead, Aishwarya, please.
So I want to know what exactly is the meaning of literature review and confessional writing.
Okay. I'm sure you are referring to the last slides I referred in my presentation. And these two are two different things. When I'm talking about literature review, I'm talking about understanding the work already done so far in the chosen area of research. But when I'm talking about confessional writing, I'm talking about the works that some writers have already maybe written in that particular genre. The experiences of researchers, the experiences of the writers, I referred this particular term in that context.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Aishwarya. So an information to all the participants here, I have already posted the feedback form in the chat box, and it will be valid only for 3 hours. So the feedback form's link is going to expire at 6:30. So I request everyone to fill the feedback form. Anyone else would like to ask their question? All right. So I presume that everybody is very, everybody has done with their question answer session. And if you read at the comments of the chat box, they have found your presentation to be very informative and quite engaging. You were doubting our attention span, but everybody has been there till the end, and they have enjoyed your presentation to the course. So at the fag end, I would like to give a vote of thanks to everyone. It's an I can no other answer make but to thank and thank, as Shakespeare says. And I would like to thank the management of RCOEM for allowing us to rope in one of the erudite scholars in Central India, whose international fame has brought in so much of overwhelming response to us, Dr. Vivek Joshi. In the same time, I cannot thank enough the executive body of INET, who were very happy to collaborate with us, and that's what INET stands for. That is bringing in quality education to the students through its teachers, and their endeavor is worth appreciating. So thank you, INET. At the end, I would like to thank all the participants for getting yourself buckled up for this exciting session, and for being with me and I'm very happy that you all were able to attend the session hassle-free. So happy attending, and wish you all a very happy and healthy life ahead. So our association still continues. Thank you very much.
Thank you all. Should I